Good morning, children.
Today's topic is communalism. How communalism is involved in politics? What is communalism and how it is involved in politics? Which means the problem begins when the religion is seen as the basis of a nation. For example, we can say when Pakistan is a religious state, India is following secularism. What differences we can find? Pakistan follows their rules and regulations all based on their holy book, Islamic book. Okay, so they follow their, even their constitution is prepared on the basis of their religious text or the holy book. Where in India, we have never followed any religious books for the preparation of constitution. All the rules and regulations are not at all based on any religion. But the problem in some cases begins when there is a nation is following any particular religion. Okay, we have studied about the Sri Lanka in the case of why communal clashes, why communal violence occurred there, because they followed majoritarian policies there. The Sinhala community and following Buddhism, they propagated particular religion there, even though it is democracy. So here we also have studied about the previous chapter about the Ireland, the particular religion. There is most of the people believe in one religion only, but the believers have different practices. So these all differences within one religion also. We know that India has many religions, so communal clashes or violence is common. But in some other countries where there is only one religion, within the religion there are many different practices. So that also creates communal violence. Okay, so when the people begins to think that our religion or our community is greater than the others, so there are some minority communities also, minority religious groups also. In India, we know that some religious groups are a majority and some are minorities. So the majority community or majority religious groups feel that they are dominant, they are superior than others. There starts communal clashes, there starts communal violence. So many groups of religions are there in our country, and also we know that some particular parties promote religions also. For example, we know that BJP's Hindutva agenda, when they came to power, then during the election campaign, they were propagating the religious agenda, Hindutva agenda, and they came to power. If they continue to follow the same religion as the base of their governing, so that minorities feel that they are not given appropriate participation and their demands are not accepted, there starts some communal violence. Also, the majority groups feel superior to other minority communities. They also mostly play the tricks of religious violence also here. So communal politics is based on the idea that the religion is the principal basis of social community. Mostly in the politics also, when these communal clashes also involve in the politics, this type of people feel that communal politics is based on the idea of religion is the principal basis of social community. It's community is based on religion. Okay, so some groups feel that community is based on the religion. So here communalism involves thinking the following lines: the followers of a particular religion must belong to one community. We know that is also one problem, and we have seen the case of Punjab. The Sikh community wanted a separate state on the basis of their religion. Like that, when one community feels that they need a separate state or separate country, there starts communal clashes. We can say the best example, Pakistan was divided from India. India and Pakistan were together or one country, it was considered, but later partition took place. So Pakistan was divided from India. That was because of this feeling that one religion needs one country or one state or one nation. Such kind of feelings if arise in between within a country, within a state, this type of communal clashes. Okay, now the interest, the belief of the fundamentally flawed people of one religion do not have the same interest in every context. We know that within one religion there are oppositions. So within one religion there are many castes also are there, and these castes also are not considered equal. We know ancient India there were upper castes, lower castes. There are differences within one region, one religion. Hinduism was followed in our country, still there were differences. Many castes were within our within one religion. So all these followers, all the followers of a particular caste or community or religion, there are if exist, coexist in a country together, there is a problem of communal violence. Most common expression of communalism is everyday beliefs also. There are some changes, some differences in between different communities. Okay. So here, communal mind often leads to a quest for political dominance of one's own religion, and other minority groups are dominated by the majority communities. Okay, so for those belonging to the minority community, it can take the form of desire to form a separate political form or political unit. We know that minority communities and their demands are not accepted by the majority community or the government. They form separate political units. We know that all the majority religions have political units or political parties also. So another form of political mobilization of religion is using of the sacred symbols. We know that the sacred symbols, every religion has particular sacred symbols. Okay, these symbols are used in government or in politics also, some cases. That also creates communal violence between the different religious groups. So these religious leaders are also promoting, are also coming into politics. That is another form of violence can be created there. Religious leaders are involved in politics. They are becoming politicians also. So their community also follows them. These all creates some kind of communal violence. In electoral politics, this often involves special appeal to the interests of emotions of voters in one religion to preference others, in preference to others. We know that religious leaders, they support particular political party, or they also promote their politics so that the religion is involved in politics. Also sometimes communal clashes occur because of that. Minority communities and majority communities are often clashes are occur. Sometimes communalism takes the most ugly form of communal violence, riots and massacre, the killing of large number of people recently, which occurred in Bangladesh. We have got the news that communal violence between two religious groups occurred. So India and Pakistan suffered on the worst communal riots during the time of partition. We know people were fighting each other in the name of religion. Hindus in Pakistan were sent to India, and Muslims in India were sent to Pakistan during the partition. So the border regions there were communal violence, killing of a large number of people occurred during this time. The post independence, after the independence also, many cases of communal violence are occurring. Many cases are there. Still we know that it is continuing. It will never end unless government makes such kind of law or enacts law. It will never be ended. So it communal politics is also a part of Indian politics.